While 10 New York City police officers committed suicide this year, the city has a new initiative announced Thursday to address the problem. Nate Rogers spoke to the sister of one of those officers.
Bob, Eileen Echeverria says she reached out to the NYPD 6 times about her brother's severe mental illness. She says they investigated, took his guns away, and then gave them back.
This was 100% preventable. I begged them. I drove there. I wrote them. I called them.
56-year-old Robert Echeverria killed himself inside his Laurelton, Queens home August 14th. Since then, his sister Eileen has spoken to nearly 100 NYPD officers and families who say the major problem is within the department.
You can't push a loyal officer so far that they no longer care. You can't tell them that they can't have a day off because they didn't, you know, do A, B, or C.
A partnership with New York Presbyterian Hospital called Finest Care will provide free mental health services to NYPD officers. Police can call a 24-hour hotline and schedule an appointment with a mental health professional. Leaders say the calls will be kept confidential.
It has been set up so that no one at the NYPD will know that an appointment has been made or that you've sought service.
Now, Echeverria isn't sold on the plan. She says officers still fear retaliation through any department-connected service.
They're going to be afraid that no matter what they say, it's going to get back. They're going to deem them unstable, and then they're going to lose all their overtime, either forced to retire, pushed out, or whatever.
Echeverria also says the department must be more proactive and not wait for officers to come to them. Most importantly, officers should know there is help available. More information about the hotline is on my Twitter page at Nate Wants to Know. In New York, I'm Nate Rogers for Chasing News.